Democrats are under attack for their hypocrisy all throughout May.
Well, first off, let me say I plan on supporting and helping the VP Joe Biden.
In a Sunday interview, Minnesota Congresswoman Ilhan Omar, a devout Muslim, said she believes the sexual assault allegations made against Democratic frontrunner Joe Biden. Despite this, she is still expressing support for the Obama vice president, tweeting, quote, "Believing survivors is consistent with my values," and that she will vote for him and help him defeat Trump. Omar is not the only one sharing this view. Earlier in the month, the New York Times ran an op-ed telling Democrats to, quote, "suck it up and make the utilitarian bargain and vote for Joe." But accusations against Biden are not the only thing putting Democrats in hot water with voters. As lockdowns continue, governors in multiple states are being lambasted for disobeying their own executive instructions. Michigan Governor Gretchen Whitmer came under fire after her husband was caught requesting to dock their boat near their lakefront home, 150 miles from the state capital, an area she told residents not to travel to. Illinois Governor J.B. Pritzker is also taking heat after reports exposed that he and his family were vacationing at their horse farm in Racine, Wisconsin.
You know, we have a working farm. They're there now. There are animals on that farm. That is an essential function.
The revelation comes less than 1 week after the governor threatened state residents with jail time for violating lockdown orders and explicitly instructed Illinoisans not to travel out of state. Despite media depicting these Democrat figures as being exemplary leaders in their states, it appears political consistency is not on the agenda in 2020.
This election is one that has character on the ballot.
Joseph Enders, Church Militant, Detroit.